In this tutorial, I will show you how to do an impact analysis using ANSYS Explicit Dynamics. For this purpose, we will do a simple project step by step, and on each step, we will review the relevant points. We can use impact analysis to find the impulse and displacement of a body for small time steps. Consider these simple examples. A car hits another car, or a bullet that impacts a wall. In the next few minutes, we'll do a simple analysis for the second example. My name is Brian, and welcome to the ANSYS world. Select an explicit dynamic analysis and place it on the project area. In the first step, we define the material. We use nonlinear materials for impact analysis. These materials have nonlinear properties that are essential for this analysis. After defining the material, it is time to draw the geometry of the problem. In this project, we want to study a simple geometry, and for this, the design modeler is quite suitable. Select the plane where we want to draw our design. Now we place a square with a length and width equal to 20 by 20 centimeters. For convenience, we move this square to the middle of the page. We place the two dimensions relative to the coordinate axis. We set each of these dimensions equal to 10 centimeters. In this way, our two-dimensional design is transferred to the center of the page. In the next step, from this two-dimensional square, we create a plate with a thickness of 2.5 centimeters. This is our plate that we are going to make hole in it. The next step is to create a two-dimensional design for the bullet. For this purpose, as you can see, we use lines and an arc to draw half of the bullet. Dimensions of this design are taken from a real example of a calibre 22 bullet. We also consider the distance of the bullet to our steel plate and set it equal to 1 millimeter. Using the revolve feature, we rotate our two-dimensional design 360 degrees, and thus our bullet is created. Now, we name each of the objects we created, the plate as a steel wall and the bullet as a bullet. Here you see a close-up of the geometry we drew. In the next step, we open the mechanical environment window. First, for the steel plate, we assign a structural steel material that we defined in the first step. We also use stainless steel for the bullets. We also control the connection between the bullet and the steel plate so that there is no connection between them, and the only connection between them is through the body interaction of the objects. The interaction in this project is considered frictionless. To define the mesh, we use the sizing option. In this project, we need to use a fine mesh to consider the smallest geometry deformation and also to increase our convergence speed of solving. For this purpose, we select the edges of the steel wall and set its element size equal to 2 mm. Then we define the initial velocity of the bullet. For this purpose, we select the bullet, and we set its speed perpendicular to the steel wall equal to 900 meters per second. This is the speed at which caliber 22 bullets are usually fired from a rifle. Also, in the analysis settings section, we need to adjust the end time to 30 microseconds. That's the duration of the total analysis. Now, we want to fix our wall. To do this, we fix the side panels of the wall using the support. In the results section, it is important for us to know how the overall plastic strain of the structure changes. Also, von Mises stress can be useful. After we have made all the relevant settings in the mechanical environment, we can order the problem for solve. As you know, finite element software does the solution in three general steps. The first part is preprocessing, the second part is processing, which is exactly this step, and the third part is post-processing, which is related to reviewing and extracting the desired results. Here you can see the conversion of the energy from kinetic to the internal energy during the solution time. Now, the animation of the total deformation of the model is ready. And here, from a closer look, we can see the cross-section of the steel wall and the bullet. When the bullet hits the wall, we can see the exact amount of equivalent plastic strain. As we can see, the 2.5 cm plate is completely resistant to this bullet. We can also see the directional deformation of the wall, and exactly how much our steel wall has deformed perpendicular to its surface. We can actually measure how much the bullet has penetrated into the steel plate. As you can see, the bullet could penetrate up to 7.6 millimeters into the steel plate. All these results in minutes and with a powerful computer simulation. Isn't that wonderful? Thank you for joining us in this tutorial.